Hello, greetings. This is Gilles Monseigneur. I thought I'd come and say hello, for I'm still have the time. I haven't really been called to speak, but I thought I'd come and make one more video. Maybe I will, for sure, I will continue to make those videos, but they may be completely transformed as my life is transformed because there's so much that is about to shift. Spirit, when I ask for guidance, they talk to me about happiness, they talk to me about celebration, they talk to me about freedom. So I'm not really receiving any guidance, but to align with this possibility that is becoming so strong within me. I wanted to speak about a subject that is essential, that there must be a lot of people have asked me questions from the comment sections about soul plan. What is our soul plan? What is it? Because when we fulfill our soul plan, we find fulfillment, we find happiness, we find joy. It means being aligned with the design of our soul. Before we came into this incarnation, we had a very precise, we designed everything in a very precise way, and all the way, even those people that are suffering a lot, when we suffer, it's because we designed it that way, because we had to learn certain lessons and free ourselves from those, from whatever energetic dynamics that we need to be freed from. And so it is like we came in before we were into incarnation, we made a design, we drew with pencils all the design of our incarnation, and now we incarnated, we just asked to solidify this design by experiencing what we've already planned for. And we've made contract with many people that were complementary in fulfilling those life plans. Certain people are pushing buttons that are negative things, and others that are bringing joy and happiness and fulfillment into our life. This is part of our life plan, to forgive those who, because those who are teaching us negative experiences are just here to force us to choose good, to choose love. So they're all as useful, and they're all part of this great unfoldment. So our soul plan, in a sense, reveals itself step by step. It's something that we our soul can reveal to us through meditation, through dreams and understanding. Sometimes we come into an incarnation, we can fulfill a lot more than what we desire, what we thought originally. We will not maybe. And sometimes we some people are they fall into drugs and alcohol. So they move or whatever, and they get distracted, and they kind of lose a lot of. They do not fulfill all those things, but yet it is always perfect, and we always have time as eternal beings. The first condition for our life plans, to fulfill our life plans, is the condition in which we were born, in which family we chose to be incarnated. For when Mozart came into incarnation, he chose to be in a musical family. If he were living in a in a peasant home, or even in a royal home, he would have never been able to fulfill his life plan in creating all this magnificent music. Same thing with Picasso. He was born, his father was teacher in fine arts. So we all come into the circumstances that will give us the most opportunity to fulfill our life plan. And then our life plan can be realized and discovered by the deep desire we have within ourselves, our dreams, those things we dream to create. For me, it's like living in a French person. It's like I do not have the dream or the ambition to become a sumo master. It's like if I would have wanted to have this kind of incarnation, I would have be born in Japan, you understand. So we all have a relevance to that which we came to live, and the deepest we feel something, the more real it is in relationship to our soul plan. For all the details are not worked out in advance, but the general line is already been planned. Well, I hope this will assist those seeking your life plan. So just stay close to your heart, and whatever you feel deeply, your deepest passion, your deepest dreams, and your deepest desires have to be part of your life plan. And then if we do not fulfill all those things that we planned for in this lifetime, then we'll have other lifetime. Life is eternal. There is nothing to rush. Yet it's so it is all part of this one unfolding process. But we do want to... We came here we to integrate this lifetime is very much about letting go of all the hundreds of lifetime we had on this planet, to disengage from all negative, so we can find this true freedom. For this, there's a purification that is needed. The purification is really hard. Not everybody is willing, able, and available to create this purification in order to free themselves. First, we have to purify our mind, to think good thoughts, and then we have to clear the physical body to allow more of the spiritual energy of our spirit and soul to embody our physical body, but it's all part of the process. The universe is assisting, and when we are no longer called to repeat the old cycle, if we're not, I'm going to pull a few cards. Well, I hope this this made sense to you, for we all came with to follow your dreams, follow your desires, follow your deepest feeling, let go of thoughts, analyzing. For some time we do not know how things work, how can we make our dream come true. And from a soul perspective, it's not about being having a plan to make it happen. It's about letting go and trusting, and the universe can find magical way to bring it into our life. Yet we want to move as close as possible to the energy of that which we've been asking, to feel comfortable around the energy of what we've been asking, and activate flows and momentum that will favor that. I'm going to pull 10 cards with this is the tarot of Casanova, which is Casanova was a great writer, romantic writer from Venice, and so it's just like an erotic or romantic deck. And so the situation is about the four of pentacles is a card of discipline, but it's also about giving and receiving. It's about being wise with how we spend our resources. So it's about keeping things to be wise in relationship to how we spend our money, but it's also receiving. Receiving is also giving, and giving is also receiving. It is part of the same process. What comes around the situation is the Nine of Pentacles. The Nine of Pentacles tells us that that even small things that improve the quality of our life has to be received with gratitude. Sometimes we're looking for that big piece that will make life, transform our life, but sometimes we're getting small pieces, and all the small pieces put together will create a big piece. So accept all the little gain that can come into your life, all the relationship, everything is contributing to everything that increase your quality of life has to be received with gratitude. What we see before us, that will unfold before us in our conscious mind, is the Nine of Cups. The Nine of Cups, it's like a Kama Sutra position called the elevator. It's the dream come true. It is something that dream that is the card that always, the Nine of Cups in the tarot, is the dream come true. Along with the stars, is the two cards that bring us our dreams. And so we can see this dream coming true. We do not know how, we do not know when, we do not know who necessarily, but we know what it is, and we know with the... But yet allow yourself to be surprised. What we have in our deep thoughts and deep in our subconscious in the past is the card of justice. The card of justice is the card of balance. It is the card of equilibrium. We have a line with this sense of highest good. We are highest good, and so we need to bring it into balance. And so it is already been done. There is already a balance that's been installed. And for now, the situation we are in that is living is the Four of Swords. The Four of Swords is isolated in a prison cell. But it's about being patient. It's about allowing the expansion to happen, to control the expansion of your mind, and to be patient enough to allow enough time for time does not exist in essence, it's just now, but it's for you to align with that which you desired, so it can come into being in a natural way. And then we have what's coming up in the near future, what's right around the corner, is the Queen of Cups. The Queen of Chalice here. So the Queen of Cups, she's the feminine side of femininity. It's about expressing your emotion. Do not be afraid to express your emotions and in a positive way. And so the more you are able to express your emotion, the more fulfillment you will find. For it's about thinking less and feeling more. And it's like somebody that's looking yourself in the palm, when you realize that you're not the reflection you see in the palm, but the palm tells you that you're not the physicality of it, you are the interaction of energy, you are consciousness. And so it's about also finding this love and to be able to express love and to have this love mirror back to us. What we are in this situation, the strengths we have in this situation, is the Knight of Swords. The Knight of Swords is a card of intuition. It's about letting go of the small self, the many small self that we have, in order to emerge into a greater self. But then once we emerge into a greater self, we can cut out the ties to the little self and trust that this higher self is far greater than all those little self that we have leaving behind. What comes to us from the outside world is the King of Pentacles. It's the investor, it is the harvest, it is the benefactor, it is all the the abundance. It is a card of abundance, that someone that reflects the sun upon us. And so once we, so it's about accepting that we're part of a collective whole, and we're complementary to each other, and we all are function in relationship to our soul plan. And so it's the card of abundance that comes to us from the outside world. What we feel inside, and there is the king and the queen here, and of the of pentacles, a lot of pentacles, a lot of material thing, material success. For materiality it's not the ins and outs like we used to think. It is just a means by which to anchor the energy into the world. And what we feel in our inner emotion, our hopes and fear, is intimacy. It is abundance. It is celebration. It is the Three of Cups is really much the card of love and sharing and celebration, to accept the fact that life is about to become like a great celebration, and every day waking up in this sense, wow, I'm alive, and it's like more to enjoy rather than fighting the old programming. So it's like being grateful about this, that the old cycle has ended. And the outcome is the Queen of Pentacles. The Queen of Pentacles, she's the one who brings the abundance. She's very, very much abundant. She's the one who's she's been through this long desert, but now everything is flourishing. So it's about being grateful for the abundance and enjoying it serenely, with serenity, with being able to enjoy all without attachment. Well, I hope this resonated with you and will make sense. I wanted to say that once when we work for the one, when we work for the highest good of all, our highest good and the highest good of all, there is amazing invisible forces that are assisting us in the process. So know that you're always connected to an invisible team of helpers and guides and amazing spiritual personality. When we breathe in and we breathe out, it's something very important to be conscious of our breathing, to let go of this shallow breathing, to be unconscious breathing, to move into the conscious breathing, the deep breathing. We're breathing in God and we're breathing out God. We're breathing in light and we're breathing out love. So it's all about understanding that all is God. And all is God. There is nothing that's not God. And God has created life, and we're always saying, well, this is not good enough, or I'm not good enough, or this is not good enough. We're always in that, in saying that it is not good enough. If it's not good enough, change it, make it better. And so, but understand, it's plenty good enough. Life is good enough. Ashtar, a friend Ashtar, was said that humans spend more time in complaining than appreciation, move into appreciation of what is good rather than complain about what appears to be not good enough. We can always retransform things as we go. If you do not like any aspect of your life, release it, transform it, recreate it. There is no outside. The outside is an illusion, even something I realized a long time ago. It's just perception. We perceive and we create and recreate those reflections as an outer world, but materiality and the physicality of things is just a vehicle for consciousness. Everything is consciousness, and consciousness is within. And as I recently I came into the sort of series of books from a philosopher named Immanuel Kant. It was the Three Critics, but in the first critique he realized, an 18th century philosopher, he realized that everything is given through the intuition, and the intuition brings it into the mind that finds a way to relate it into an understanding form into the outer world. But everything is just perception. In essence, in truth, we cannot move. There is no way we can move, because we already are there. We cannot get any closer to God than we already are, for we always have been one. For you and God are always been one. There is no distance, there is no destination, there is just being, and this beingness is evolving and growing into something that's far more magnificent than anything we could have suspected when we were part of this illusionary process. So essentially, sometimes we have to accept to make baby steps, and sometimes we make giant leap forward. So it's about accepting the process as it is, and breathing and being content with what is, and content with the step we make, and being gratitude and appreciation and cheer, be the best, that we are cheerleader for yourself, to always be in the support, in the assistance, in the process of all of life, but yourself as well. And to let go, to be kind with yourself, and so allow us to be kind with the world. So I'm going to pull a few more cards with the Archangel Tarot. I'm going to sing a song. I wasn't sure what to sing because there was no songs really went through my mind. But the paintings behind me, this is like an abstract nude. It's, I kind of like it. It's in the interior. There's some several details, and there is this painting of those two people here, and there is a. So it's an abstract nude. I'm going to soon find a new model for portraits and nudes. For enjoy making it from photos or for imagination, but it's the dynamism with a model is really fun, and it's like. Going to do some more figurative, those are more abstract expressionist, more figurative. And this is part of the two paintings. Yesterday I showed a painting about the seven principal chakras, which is the microcosm, and this is the macrocosm, the other side of our light body, which connects us to the higher planes. It's called the tree of life, so it's like, and it starts with the crystal earth, our sun, the etheric father sun, the etheric mother sun, then it goes into the midway station, that leads us to the Pleiades. On this side you have Arcturus and Antares, which is and then there is, it leads us to Sirius, which leads us to the galactic center, the Omega Father Galaxy, and the Alpha Mother Galaxy, and then the Omnigalactic Source above, where it's like this light body will unfold into a universal phenomenon, and we'll be able to travel in the universe once we open the door to the skies, and we're completely free. So I'm going to sing this song. It's a band. It's an old song, but it's a band called The Fifth Dimension. And the song is called The Age of Aquarius. It goes like this. When the moon is in the seventh house and Jupiter aligns with Mars, then peace will guide the planets and love will steer the stars. This is the dawning of the Age of Aquarius. Age of Aquarius, Aquarius, Aquarius. Harmony and understanding, sympathy and trust abounding, no more falsehoods or derisions, golden living dreams of vision, mystic crystal revelation, and the mind's true liberation. Aquarius, Aquarius. When the moon is in the seventh house and Jupiter aligns with Mars, then peace will guide the planets and love will steer the stars. This is the dawning of the Age of Aquarius. Age of Aquarius, Aquarius, Aquarius. Let the sun shine. Let the sun shine in, the sun shining. Let the sun shine. Let the sun shine in, the sun shining. Let the sun shine. Let the sun shine in, the sun shining. So it is about letting the sun shine inside of us to become one with the light. It is very much an age of the age of angels, the age of self-liberation, the age of freedom and peace for all of humanity. That is what's going to last for 2,000 years. And then after that, we're going to move into this golden age. It's part of the beginning of the golden age that will become a platinum age, and eventually we'll move into, fuse into light and life, and the planet will be spiritualized. So it is very exciting. No matter what can be shown in the outside world, that's still the old ways, will still appears to be continuing, but it's everything has been disempowered, all the old has been disengaged. So we want to disengage and move into this connective self. I'm going to pull four cards with the Archangel. So the highest wisdom is that we must find a balance. It's the Two of Ariel. It's about running more than one. To be able to do many things at one time, to make every work more enjoyable. So it's about finding ways to make everything more enjoyable. What we need to understand is the Ten of Raphael. Life is made of love and grace, family relationship that are harmonious, looking for happiness. It's about finding joy, finding satiety, finding the complement in the world. What we need to do is the king of Michael, which has principles, rational, ambitious, respected. Let wisdom and objectivity be dominant. Have integrity. The situation must be dealt with honesty and necessitate a good communication. So it's about, very much a card of management and to be clear. And the outcome is the Five of Gabriel. The Five of Gabriel is it says that you can undertake any challenges. Move away from people living tragic situations. Be patient towards you and others. So it's about not allowing the dramas of the world to interfere with our joy, yeah? to move away from all those people. They're all fulfilling their karmas, they're all fulfilling their life plan in order to be free from those dramas. And so it is not, it doesn't mean we want to send light and love into that, but we do not want to get personally involved with other people's drama. Well, thank you very much for liking, sharing, subscribing. I wish you a wonderful day, and I'll talk to you later. Namaste.